While the Great Barrier Reef Islands are beautiful and boast some really great holiday options, you don't have to travel 50 nautical miles out to sea to get a taste of island life. Nestled in the Gladstone Harbour, just a short 15-minute boat ride from the mainland is the exclusive Quoin Island Retreat.
So first a chopper, then a boat with wheels, and now the little engine that could. Talk about seeing the area in three ways.
Quoin Island Retreat only opened its doors to visitors last year and really is one of those well-kept secrets.
This place really is paradise. Have a look at that for a backdrop. But perhaps its most attractive feature is that Gladstone is just a quick 15-minute boat run across the harbour, so you can come here for a day or be like me and spend the night.
After the break, catch me as I explore this paradise and meet the man behind Gladstone's latest holiday island getaway. Waking up on the idyllic Quoin Island Retreat just off the coast of Gladstone is like waking up in paradise. But things weren't always so perfect. It's an island rags-to-riches fairy tale, and the knight in shining armour is local Gladstone man Bob McCosker. He purchased the island in 2009 and set out to rebuild the dilapidated remains of a once high-flying resort.
Tell me, are you mad picking Quoin Island after, what, 15 years of it just lying here to the elements?
I think that's a good question, Kimberly. It's most probably a yes.
Yeah?
It's a big yes.
So it was something that you've wanted to do for a while?
No, I was mad.
Bob is the owner and managing director of a civil contracting company in Gladstone. So the businessman saw the project as one big and very exciting challenge.
Look, it really was like Beirut, I suppose. I mean, the pool, for example, was broken into three pieces. It was full to the top with palm fronds. None of the pavers even up the top. It took us about 6 weeks to even realise that there were pavers here.
And I cannot believe you didn't turn around and run in the other direction.
Well, it was fun. I mean, you know, the owners had effectively, literally just walked out. So there was lots of the old treasures from, you know, 20 odd years ago and old price lists and that sort of stuff.
Wow.
So there's a bit of fun involved in it.
It took 3 years of construction to get things back up and running, a particularly hard feat considering the resort is now fully self-sufficient, meaning they manage and produce all their own power, sewage and water, a luxury that is now enjoyed by the McCosker family every day of the week.
Did you always have the dream of living here as well? Because you commute every day?
Yes, we do now. Look, to be absolutely honest, when we first come over and even during construction, I had no desire to live here. I'd never had the thought that we would ever live on an island. But it was only after the first year then we moved over actually for a Christmas with the family.
Yeah.
And that was 3.5 years ago.
So what happened? You decided you just didn't want to leave?
Absolutely, yeah. And I think the longer we stay, the more you don't want to leave. It just becomes a real pleasurable thing to do.